This video is a two-part collaboration with fellow YouTuber Arvin Ash. Together, we are going to discuss the scale of the universe in numbers, with some pretty mind-blowing facts and figures. So make sure you check out Arvin's video and incredible channel after this video.
The universe is magical and mysterious, and humans are ever looking to understand how it works and what makes it tick. One way our brains make sense of things is with mathematics, statistics, and numbers, helping give us perspective on all we know, from the tiniest specks of matter to the gargantuan scale of space and all the wonders it holds. Today, we're going to take you on an adventure in numbers, showing you some of the most important numbers in science, starting small and intricate, working our way up to dizzying, awe-inspiring numbers. So let's go. There's only one place to start, and that is zero.
Zero, number, total energy in the universe, positive-negative balance. Matter, antimatter, and light are all classed as positive energy, so you would think that with so much light and even explosions from all the stars in the universe, energy would be positive in balance. But as the gravitational energy between atoms and objects are classed as negative, this actually cancels out the positive energy.
Stephen Hawking explained it like this. Two pieces of matter that are close to each other have less positive energy than the same two pieces a long way apart, because you have to expend energy to separate them against the gravitational force that is pulling them together.
Since it takes positive energy to separate the two pieces of matter, gravity must be using negative energy to pull them together. In the case of a universe that is approximately uniform in space, one can show that this negative gravitational energy exactly cancels the positive energy represented by the matter. So the total energy of the universe is zero. Let's not waste any energy wrecking our heads over this.
This incredibly small number is Planck time. This is regarded as the smallest unit of time that has any meaning. It is the time a photon traveling at the speed of light would take to travel a Planck length, the smallest measure of distance we have, which is thought to make up the quantum foam on which space-time is built. It is 20 powers of 10 smaller than the diameter of a hydrogen nucleus. The laws of physics state that the universe could only be classified as existing after it lived for this amount of time.
1. Hydrogen. Number 1 of the periodic table, with one electron orbiting one proton, hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe, and probably the first that ever existed. 4. Number of fundamental forces. We're not forcing you to watch this video, but let's explain the hidden forces that make it possible for you to do so. First, we have gravity, which acts as an attractive force between any two masses, and is trying to pull you and your atoms into the center of the Earth right now. Naughty gravity.
Now, the reason we don't is the second force, electromagnetism, which can interact with any atoms and molecules with an electrical charge through repulsion and attraction, together keeping you and the floor as one piece. I think I like this force.
The third is the weak nuclear force, which is responsible for nuclear beta decay. This is when a neutron within the nucleus changes into a proton and an electron, which is then ejected from the nucleus. This force ultimately enables the existence of stars and our sun.
The fourth is the strong nuclear force, which binds the nuclei of atoms together. The force is strong enough to keep two protons that normally repel each other together, making it the strongest of the four forces. Without these forces, you would not exist, and probably matter wouldn't exist either. 5, as in 5% of our visible universe. This, amazingly, is the small percentage of mass of the universe all around us that we have been able to observe and quantify. The remainder is still all around us, but so far remains invisible, around 25% being dark matter and 70% known as dark energy.
11. Dimensions theorized by string theory. This is the amount of dimensions proposed in the universe when unifying the relationships of the five prominent string theories, known as M theory or membrane theory. String theory replaces all the matter and forces in the universe with tiny vibrating strings that twist and turn in ways to make up every single particle. And all the different types of particles in the universe will have a different note that distinguishes it and forms the cosmic symphony we are part of.
The first dimension is like a line of two connecting points, with width the only measurement to exist. The second dimension adds height, and any basic flat space you can imagine exists here. The third dimension is where we exist and adds depth to the equation. But time does not exist here. That is added as the fourth dimension. Time gives any object existing in three dimensions a location where it can exist in the universe.
Now begins the higher dimensions, which are theorized to exist but are imperceptible to us, as they are believed to exist on a subatomic level. We won't explain them all, as your head might explode, but the seventh dimension enables multiple universes, all with their own beginnings and own individual laws of nature that make them up. The eighth holds every single possible outcome of past and present for all the universes in the seventh dimension. The 11th dimension is thought to be the maximum because of self-consistency. Any more, and they would become unstable and collapse back down to the maximum of 11 anyway. In the 11th dimension, anything and everything is possible. All pasts, futures, beginnings, and ends are laid bare, and you would be able to manipulate or change any part of this you desire. And to think this is theorized to exist and be all around us right now, but be totally inaccessible to us. Science is mad.
42, the number that is the true meaning of life. Okay, we're only joking here. This was the number that supercomputer Deep Thought came up with after millions of years of processing in The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. A great movie. If you haven't checked it out, check it out. Who knows? Maybe Deep Thought knows something we don't? 98, as in 98%. The abundance of hydrogen and helium in the universe accounts for 98% of all normal matter. 74% is hydrogen and 24% is helium. Every other element in the universe, oxygen, carbon, iron, and all the others that we're familiar with, only add up to the remaining 2%.
118. Elements in the periodic table. The number of elements in the universe we have discovered weighs in at 118. Everything around you right now is made up of a combination of these elements. 94 of the elements have been found to naturally occur on Earth. The remaining 24 have yet to be found on Earth or in space naturally and have been created artificially. The numbers generally increase with atomic mass. Anything over 100 in the table is so unstable when created, it usually only lasts for a few milliseconds before decaying into lighter elements. 380, wavelength in nanometers of the color violet. The shortest color wavelength the human eye can see in the visible light spectrum. Any lower and it's not visible to us.
500 is the time in seconds light takes to hit us from the sun. Light emitting from the sun travels at 186,282 miles per second. The light we're seeing from the sun has taken 8.2 minutes to reach us, or 500 seconds.
700. Wavelength in nanometers of the color red. On the high end of the visible light spectrum is the color red, its wavelength being 700 nanometers a second. Anything higher is classed as infrared. Now over to Arvin's channel, where we will discuss the scale of the universe all the way up to infinity and beyond. Okay, maybe just infinity. Click the link on screen here or find it in the description below. Show us some love. Click subscribe and the bell icon for more videos.